Hello, I'd like to show you how to calculate the Viterbi matrix for this given sequence to specify the best post-tag sequence, so the best tagging possibility for this sequence. That means the one with the highest probability. I will give you the most important facts first, and then I will show you the calculation so you can decide on your own how much detail you need. And we have here some probabilities given, some emission probabilities, which were may retrieved from a text. And in this case, that would mean that we had some amount of nouns, and the amount that the nouns were used to tag the word changes that were about 3 × 10⁻³ cases, so in 3 thousandths of the cases. And we also got some transition probabilities, and it may be a little bit confusing that we use conditional probabilities. So this one would mean you will read it like the probability for a noun given a verb, but if you compare to the sequence, you would if you compare to the sequence, you would encounter the verb first. So the probability that for the amounts of time you had a verb which were followed by a noun. So it may be a little bit confusing that this is that they are the other way around than they occurred in the sequence. And in general, if you go through the calculation process, in general you will always have to multiply three numbers with each other. So one will be from the previous entry of the Viterbi matrix. One number will be from the emission probabilities, and one will be from transition probabilities. So if you calculate the a possible tag for a word, you will in general multiply those three numbers with each other, except in two cases, and that's at the beginning and at the end. So at the beginning you don't have a previous entry of the Viterbi matrix, and the end won't have any emission probabilities because there are not different kinds of endings. And well, we for one cell we will keep we will just keep the probability the highest probability possible for the cell. But if we have several cells filled and we want to decide which one of these we want to use, then we have to calculate both possibilities and keep the highest from that. So that are the basics, and now I will go through the calculation process with you. I think I will not do the whole sequence because it's just too long. I will just start. So at the beginning, I want to calculate the probability that learning is tagged by as a verb. I'm not writing out the full word because it just takes me too long to write. So we don't have a previous Viterbi in entry, but we have an emission probability, and the probability that learning is tagged as a verb is 3 × 10⁻³. And now we want to have a transition probability. And I forgot to mention, the beginning of the sequence is denoted by Q0, like the initial state, and the end is denoted by Qf for final state. So we now need the transition probability that a verb followed the beginning of a sequence. And that is, in this case, this probability, 3 × 10⁻³. And that's equal to 9 × 10⁻⁶. And that's the probability we will write into this cell. So it's 9 times 10 to the power of minus 6. And now in the cell we will include a marker that tells us where we came from. So in this case we just came from the initial state. Here it might look like unnecessary, but if we calculated the whole matrix, then we can use those markers to retrieve the best sequence. Then I want to calculate the probability that learning is a noun. Now I need the emission probability for learning being a noun. It is 1 times 10 to the power of minus 3. Then I want the transition probability that after the beginning of a sequence there was a noun. And it's 2 times 10 to the power of minus 1. And that is equal to 2 times 10 to the power of minus 4. I just said I made a mistake. Of course, here the probability is to the power of minus 1 and not 3. And then we get... And then at the end we get a minus 4 here as well. So you might notice that this probability is much higher than this one, and you may want to just keep that, but when we are going to the next column, that then it could be the case that that this probability is multiplied with a very small number and the other one with a very big number, so maybe this one leads to the best sequence, and we cannot say it yet, and we have to keep both probabilities. So the probability now in this moment, in this situation, that learning is a noun is 2 times 10 to the power of minus 4, and we are coming from the beginning. And here in the other cell it must also be minus 4. Now the calculation will be a little bit more complicated. So let's begin with the probability of changes being a verb. And now we can either the one possibility is that the previous word was a verb or that the previous verb was a noun, and we have to check both cases and then keep the maximum of those. So now I'm starting with emission probabilities. The probability that changes is a verb is 4 times 10 to the power of minus 3, and it will be the case no matter where we are coming from. But the transition probabilities will be different. So in the first line, I say I'm coming from the verb. So the transition probabilities, now we have a verb, and the previous was the verb also. This probability, 1 times 10 to the power of minus 1. Or in the second case, the previous could be a noun. So we need the transition that a verb follows a noun, and that is 3 times 10 to the power of minus 1. And now we have to multiply it by the previous Viterbi entry. And in the first line, I said we are coming from the verb, so I have to multiply it by 9 times 10 to the power of minus 4. And in the second line, we are coming from the noun row, and I have to multiply it by 2 times 10 to the power of minus 4. And let me just calculate it inside here. And the first one is 9 times 4. It's, if I did not make any mistakes, it's 36. Times 3 plus 1 is 4, plus 4 is minus 8. And for the second line, 4 times 3 is 12, times 2 is 24. And now I have to keep the highest probability from both, and that is, in this case, it's the first entry. So the probability that changes is a verb, it's 3.6. Now I can now I'm moving the point to 10 to the power of minus 7 if I did not make any mistakes. And in the first line I said we are coming from the verb, so I will put here in the marker that I came from the verb entry. So that now when I'm at the end, when I'm retrieving the best post-text sequence, and this one will tell me that I'm coming from the verb, from the previous verb entry. So now I'm doing the just for demonstration, I show you the how to calculate the probability for changes being a noun. I have to calculate the maximum. And first I need the emission probability. That changes is a noun. It's 3 times 10 to the power of minus 3. And it will be the same no matter where I'm coming from. Then we need the transition probability, either that the noun follows a verb. It's 4 times 10 to the power of minus 1. Or that the noun follows another noun, and it is 1 times 10 to the power of minus 1. And now I have to multiply it with the previous Viterbi matrix entries. So in the first line I'm coming from the verb entry, and I'm multiplying it with 9, and here with 2 times 10 to the power of minus 4. And again, I have to calculate both and keep the highest entry. So it's 3 times 4 is 12, times 9 is 108. Times 3 plus 1 is 4, plus 4 is 8. And for the second line, 3 times 1 times 2 is 6, times 10 to the power of minus 8. And you see that the first entry is a greater one, and we will keep that. So it's, again, if I did not make any mistakes in the calculation, it's 10 to the power of minus 6. And again, we are coming from the verb entry. And now, I don't like to bother you with the whole calculation. So, for thoroughly, it would be nearly the same case, but thoroughly can just be an adverb. Let me just speed it up. So for thoroughly, I will calculate the emission probability 2 times 10 to the power of minus 3, and then I will check both possibilities that I am coming either from a verb or from a noun. And at the end, I will have, if my notes are correctly, 2.88 times 10 to the power of minus 10. And we are coming from the verb. And then at the end, I want to close the sequence for the ending. So basically, this will be the entry for the ending. I will again take the number from the previous cell, so this number, and I will multiply it by the transition probability that the adverb is, that the ending follows an adverb, so that will be this one, and I will get the final entry 2.88 times 10 to the power of minus 11, and I'm coming from the adverb entry. And now, if I did everything correct, I can retrieve the best post-text sequence. So at the end, there's, of course, only this one entry left. Just let me take another color for that. So at the end, I'm coming from the adverb entry. Then the adverb row tells me that I came from the verb entry. And here the verb entry tells me that I again came from the verb entry. And here it tells me that I just came from the beginning of the sequence. And that means the best post-text sequence for this sequence of words, it's based on these probabilities, which may not reflect real text statistics. But according to this example, it's verb, adverb. So, thank you for watching.